Changed the way we fought, changed everything, changed the world. The leaders of the work are well known. Everybody has heard the names. They're as well known as most of the military leaders. There's a famous letter from Einstein and Szilard to President Roosevelt, and that led to the creation of the Manhattan Project. There were also people like Oppenheimer, Bethe, Teller, Bloch, Seaborg. These are all part of undergraduate and even high school physics textbooks. And some of them even reached down to Frank Spedding and Harley Wilhelm, who I think many of you know. These are well known, but countless others, and some of you here, actually did the hard work. It wasn't, you know, Oppenheimer and Bethe and Teller, these were all theoretical physicists. They did their work with pencil and paper. The real hard work of the Manhattan Project was done in dirty labs with lots of large-scale equipment, and it's an absolutely remarkable success story. I think it's the first real success story of the U.S. picking up a project and carrying it through at that scale. And it sort of set the tone for other things that followed. NASA would never have come along had the U.S. not convinced itself that it can do big-scale science. At Ames, Spedding and Wilhelm led a team that purified 2 million pounds of uranium. 2 million pounds. It's a huge amount of material. I don't think I've ever seen 2 million pounds of metal in one place. But that was the material from which the first two bombs actually had their material extracted. The uranium and the plutonium for the first two bombs came from that very uranium. And those two, of course, led to the end of all hostilities in the Second World War. The workers in the Manhattan Project in subsequent Cold War years did absolutely remarkable work, incredible work. Often working with materials like uranium, plutonium, thorium, beryllium, mercury, asbestos, I could name a whole bunch of others that we no longer let people work with, at least not without a whole bunch of protective gear. And the health effects of those things were just not well known at the time. Those effects have emerged, and Ralph Fortes has been talking with you about how those affect you. But it's clear, it became clear later, that the Cold War took a real toll on the fighters, really. Fighters who fought in it. Those were not in uniform, they worked in labs, they wore lab coats. If they were well disciplined, they wore lab coats. Some of them didn't, I guess. Those forces, of course, were the workers that in places that are now called the National Labs. And it's really time now, it's long past time, to thank them all for the sacrifices they made that led really to a secure world for everyone. The Congressional resolution recognizes those sacrifices made by nuclear weapons and uranium workers who risked their lives in serving the country during the Cold War. And right now, it's time. We thank them all for their services to all of us. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.